Hello friends, welcome to this video on linear equations in two variables. In this video, we will solve some questions related to the graph of linear equations in two variables and increase our grip on this subject, shall we? Let's start with our first questions without wasting much time. The price of a mango is 2 rupees less than twice the price of an apple. Represent this situation in the form of a graph showing linear equation in two variables. Let's see how to solve such questions. First of all, here we have two fruits, mango and apple. We have to make an equation with two variables. So, we will consider the price of one fruit as x and the price of the other fruit as y. So, suppose the price of one apple is x and the price of one mango is y. Now, according to the condition, we will form an equation. The condition is that the price of one mango, that is y, is 2 less than twice the price of one apple. Y is 2 less than 2x, that is y is equal to 2x minus 2. The equation is ready. Now, we have to make a graph by marking their coordinates on x and y axis. How will you do this? We will make a table of x and y and find different values for x and y. If you replace x with 1 in this equation, y will become 0. If you replace x with 2, y becomes 2. By the way, two coordinate points are sufficient to draw a line. But let's find the third point also. Let's put 3 in the place of x and see what we get. Now, without wasting much time, let's draw a graph with the help of these three coordinate points. First, mark the units on x and y axis. Plot all three coordinate points. Now draw a line through these points. And this will be the graph of the equation y is equal to 2x minus 2. Now let's look at the next question. Explain how many lines can be drawn through a point and also write equations of two lines passing through the point 3, 15. First of all, infinite number of lines can be drawn through one point. And when countless lines can be drawn, all we have to do is write two such equations of lines which pass through the point 3, 15. Does this question seem difficult? The answers to these kind of questions can be derived from the given point itself. The given point has x and y coordinates. So, if we examine it carefully, we can say that when x is 3, then y is 15. That is, y is 5 times x. Y is equal to 5x. So, this is how the first equation is formed. Now, let's find the second equation. Do we only use multiplication to establish a relation between x and y? No. We can also establish a relation between them by using addition, subtraction, or division. Can we say that y is 12 more than x? That is, y is equal to x plus 12. So, we got two equations like this. Friends, can you make more than two equations? Can we establish any other relation between them? As we just saw, infinite number of lines can be drawn from a single point. Similarly, there can also be infinite relations between them. You can try to create more equations after pausing this video. Friends, let's move ahead and look at the next question of this session. For the given graph, which of the following is the correct equation? This is the easiest question. In this question, you should focus on the graph to know the points where the line intersects x and y axis. Now, place the same values of x, y in all the given equations. Here, the line intersects the x axis at minus phi and the y axis at phi. That is, we got two coordinates of x, y, that is minus phi, 0 and 0, phi. Now, we will put both these values in all the equations and find out which equation is true for these values. Re- Replacing x and y with these coordinates in equation 1 is not satisfying the equation. Similarly, equation 2 is not satisfied. When x and y are replaced by minus phi, 0 coordinates. But replacing the coordinates x and y with 0, phi is making the LHS equal to RHS. So is this the equation of this line? No. Only when both the coordinates satisfy the equation, we can call it the equation of the line. Now, let's substitute these values in equation 3. We get the LHS equal to the RHS for both the coordinates. Therefore, equation 3 is the equation of this graph. So friends, that's all in this video. In this video, we have solved some questions based on the graph of a linear equation in two variables. We'll see you in the next video with some more questions. Thank you.